and the onus on to Mitesh bhai. I just have to say one thing. Om Miteshaya Namah. He is going to give a solution to everything. To introduce Mitesh Katira, of course he is known to every one of us, but then he is a chartered accountant and ESA qualified. He specializes in business advisory services with more than 15 years of experience. He has been focusing on internal audit, compliance, outsourcing, GST implementation. He has been helping corporates and multinationals on GST impact analysis. He is assessing diverse range of businesses with implementation of VAT in GCC, mainly handling VAT implementation projects in Kingdom of Saudi Arabia. He is part of IT committee of Chamber of Tax Consultant and has been contributing on various forums, trade bodies about technology and GST implementation. With these words, I would invite Sri Ashok Sharma ji, Chairman of Direct Tax Study Circle, to present a memento to Mitesh bhai.
సేవిత పాద పంకజ కరే విరాజత్ కమనీయ పుస్తక విధేష్ట పత్ని కమలాసన ప్రియ సరస్వతి నృత్య తువాచి వేసన లెట్ ది గాడెస్ సరస్వతి డాన్స్ ఆన్ మై టంగ్ టుడే. సో విత్ దిస్ వర్డ్స్ విల్ స్టార్ట్ ది నౌ ది డెలిబరేషన్ ప్రాపర్ ఆన్ ది ప్రాక్టికల్ ఆస్పెక్ట్స్ ఆఫ్ ఈవెబిల్. హియర్ ఇస్ మై కలీగ్ మేవుల్, who has worked hard on making the practical presentation. We will take this in a manner where we will be able to display the UA bill portal and deliberate on the UA bill proper as a topic. Lot of theoretical aspects have already been covered by Manish bhai, and they have been apt enough to give you an insight as to what are the good and bad parts of the UA bill, what are the kind of complications that UA bill will be looking like. But I will want to throw some perspective around this UN cry with regards to UA bill. I think that every change is always having some kind of a resistance, and so is the GST having the resistance, so is the UA bill having the resistance, so are the other changes like demonetization and other aspects having the resistance. But the point is, without change there is lot of comfort zone that people can get into, and that is very, very harmful. So one thing is that the change always keeps one alert and upright and learning and student for life, right? Change always makes you think newer ways of adapting to it. Change always allows you to keep up your passion of learning, and change, if there is no change, there is boredom, there is stagnation, there is lack of interest, there is unnecessary lethargy getting developed in people. All these are results of not being ready to adapt to change or not changing, right? And if you look at it, people who have changed, the species who have changed, have stayed for lakhs of years, and species who denied to change, like dinosaurs, they were huge, right? But where are they today? So So the point is, as a fraternity of CAs, we have always been updating ourselves regularly, but now is the time that we adapt to the change. And if you look at the EUA bill, I would say there has been always a dilemma of the tax officer and the dealers or the people who are registered, suppliers or recipients, that whether the actual movement of goods has happened, whether it has happened interstate or intrastate, whether it has really moved from one location to another, right? And all the assessments, all the high pitch issues were with regards to what? The movement, right? If you look at C form, look at S form, I form, whatever was there, all the discussions in VAT used to be around movement, right? When you look at excise law, it was always, excise was charged when the goods started moving out of the gate, factory gate, right? So all these were issues for the SSE. I am talking on the other side of the table, that's why maybe I am talking something goody-goody, but I will say that there has to be optimism to change. It cannot be taken very, very pessimistically. Otherwise, it will not help any one of us, right? Neither us, nor department, nor the ministry, right? So when you look at all these aspects, the movement was integral part of transactions, and the movement was being done by something called as unorganized, something called as uneducated, someone not ready to learn at all in life, right? Who were transporters, right? So there was a complete missing link which was creating lot of litigations, lot of disputes, lot of issues, and it was always reactive in nature. 4 years later you were asked, bring lorry receipt for this transaction, you know, and you were getting lost. You were saying that where can I find out the lorry receipt of the 4 years old transaction or a 6 years old transaction. Now the VAT has started doing assessments and you will see all these discussions going on, right? What C form, what is the differential liability, right? The assessment bolne ke pehle differential liability ki baat hone lagti hai, right? What was this? This was because the movement was not getting established, right? And now you are, by generating EUA bill, you are putting the ball of movement in the court of the department. You are saying that I have done the movement, please check your records. You know, don't punish me by saying that LR ka hai, receipt ka hai, right? Lekin uska ye what you call back disadvantage hai ki jo 4 saal baad aapko kasrat karni hai wo aaj karni padegi. So I would say that as a SSE or as a transporter or as a recipient, I should be happier to adopt to this change, to say that the department has given me an opportunity to develop a train around movement of goods before the movement starts, right? So that I need not worry about the trail post mortem. मरने के बाद हम लोग trail ढूंढने को निकलेंगे. उससे चाहे live scenario में आपको trail generate करने का एक जबरदस्त मौका है, जबरदस्त opportunity है, right? People have started saying इसमें EUA bill नहीं बनाना है, very good. इसमें नहीं बनाना है, 10 किलोमीटर के कम है तो नहीं, non motorized में हाथ गाड़ी में लेके जाऊंगा, right? This is all stupid, believe me. We will have to, if we are in organized sector and if we want to do ethical business, I think we should generate EUA bill for everything and anything. And Mehul will show you how easy it is, right? We are not trying to, you are not being told to create a, you know, a rocket science program, right? By doing an EUA bill. You are asked to generate a challan which you used to generate manually, right? And tell me one thing, that how many suppliers didn't maintain the trail of movement of goods while the goods reached a particular destination? Arey boss, goods mera hai, tension mere ko hai. Right now the suppliers are coming and telling me that sir, ye kyun maintain karne ko lagaya ja raha hai. Arey bhai, tu pehle bhi maintain kar raha tha, right? Aisa koi hai kya? When you ask for an audit report, you ask for an inventory or valuation, you will say, where from I find the valuation? I am a retailer, I have bought many small inventories, I don't know. Then you ask him in as a businessman, that how do you run your business without knowing the inventory? He says, wo sab to pata hai, aur chupri mein likha hai na sir. Lekin wo system mein nahi hai, that's the whole point, right? Similarly, even transport trails are maintained, they are maintained physically. lot of worry and tension goes in maintaining the transport rail. When you talk to, here we will have some of the businessmen also, right? When you talk to them, you will find out that उसके पास पूरा trail है sir. उसको पता है कौन से vehicle से कौन सा vehicle में जाने वाला है, कैसे movement होने वाला है, right? He is not a fool. He is not sending crores of rupees of inventory. He is not relying on a unorganized guy. He is having some trail of it, right? But while some compliance is asked to be done, he says, "I don't trail any. I don't know. Pata hi nahi hai." All of those discussions happen. But I will say that we should become upright about this, and we should say that ये तो अच्छा है ना यार. पहले क्या हो रहा था? Courier companies had to give you the trail. That's how the movement has happened. You know, when you want to trace a parcel, you are happy to work with a blue dart instead of working with a roadside courier guy. Why? Because your parcels were tracked. Whenever you want to put your parcel number and you can track the where is the parcel today and when you expect it to reach. Similarly, now the government is trying to maintain a trail of entire transaction and giving you readily available. Why do you want to deny that? Right? I think with all the agonies and issues, we should welcome this change, right? It is a change for betterment. ठीक है, अभी उसमें बहुत लोग बोले government will then reduce like GST, then it will say ये मत रखो, वो मत रखो. All those are the discussions that are happening internally, right? All those are cooler water purifier discussions. But when you look at the idealistic situation versus the reality, it will always be a bit different, right? And why are we worried about it today? Let's look at the ideal and let's set it right so that reality is very easy for us to adopt, right? So today all of us have come and been proactive to understand these realities because we are all thinking in a positive manner and want to adopt to some things which are worth it, want to learn and want to be upright. And right, I met a gentleman, Mr. Ashok Bhai. He said that I attend all these sessions, whatever happens, right? Because कुछ ना कुछ तो नया नया समझने को सीखने को मिलेगा, right? And he says that Sholi Dastur also once congratulated him to say that, बहुत आप तो हर session में आते हैं, एक दिन मेरे office में चाय पीने को भी आओ, right? अपने को किसी को बुलाएगा नहीं. So that is the kind of learning passion that we all have, and it will be useful for us to take it up, right? Let's jump into the subject proper with this backdrop. This is the website of UAVL, very simple website, right? And this website is called as uabil.nic.in, right? Which is a very what you call project, different project from GSTN. ठीक है, एक तो लोगों के मन में GSTN का जो भय बैठ गया, वो लोग बोल रहे हैं कि GSTN कुछ भी करेगा तो गड़बड़ होने वाला है. तो गवर्नमेंट हैज डन अ वेरी गुड जॉब. दे हैव सेड दैट GSTN से इसको अलग रखो. लेट अस लेट द NIC बिल्ड दिस पोर्टल, राइट? इट इज अ फ्रेश एक्सरसाइज. इट हैज नथिंग, नो कनेक्शन विद GSTN अदर देन द डेटाबेस, राइट? व्हिच इज ऑफ कोर्स व्हाटएवर रजिस्टर्ड डीलर्स आर देयर, दे हैव पिक्ड अप द डेटाबेस एंड केप्ट इट एट द बैक एंड. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट देयर इज नो लिंक. दिस इज अ कंप्लीटली सेपरेट वेबसाइट. So let's try and see how simple is a small registration of a what you call a dealer or a registered person, right? Anyone tried to do the registration? Is there a registration here? Wow, very good. Almost 10-15 people have tried to do the registration. So good. So we will just try to do a small registration as an experiment. We have got so one good thing about this before we get into registration is up to 31st of this January, the data will be kept in this portal and then it will be flushed. So, किसी का भी registration लिया, कुछ भी email bill बनाया, tension नहीं है. It is just a what you call a trial exercise, trial period. ठीक है? So, आप आराम से खेल सकते हैं. So, if something goes wrong, there is no issue. It is very very simple and please try it out, right? So, we have made Alok Bhai, who is a chartered accountant, a supplier in this process, and we will try to register Alok Bhai, right? So we will have to just put his GSTN and all the data of from his GSTN details will be pulled out by the portal. We have to put this captcha. This is a problem, right? All the time this captcha is being asked, and one has to put, why because the robots will not pull out the information, that is the intention, right? Nowadays there are a lot of robotic softwares that are available that can pull out the data, that is why they have tried to protect. See, now the entire data of Alokbhai is generated on the website. There is no secret data, only his office and phone number etc. is there. So now Mehul can say that send an OTP to Alokbhai, you are in network. So an OTP will get sent to his mobile number. Another issue with this is, good thing and bad thing is lot of security. So all the transactions have OTP, lot of OTP backed transactions are there. So that's an issue. The good part before he gets the OTP, Mila. The good part about so the good part is there is a concept called as API, right? So we need not worry about this day-to-day transactions with lot of OTPs when we adopt an API model. Right, this is an application programming interface model which is available, and if you have transactions more than 200 UA bills daily, you can go with an API model. Say if you have a SAP or a Oracle or any other software implemented, you can link this portal to that software, and the portal, whenever you update your new invoice and create a challan, automatically will go generate an UA bill, give you the UA bill number. So that is also possible, right? So multiple modes of doing transactions. One of them is this website. The other is the mobile application, that is Android application. Android application is started, but it is having lot of flaws as of now. Third is SMS. So someone was telling me that if the internet is not working, can I generate a UA bill without internet? The answer is yes. You just need network of one of the service providers, and you have got a systematic protocol to follow. You put that data into the protocol, and the UA bill number will be popped up on your mobile itself. Right? So that is also possible. So, and the fourth is the GSP. So some of the GSPs can also allow you to generate EWA bill. Like Clear Tax has already come up with some solution, if I am not wrong. I have not seen the solution, but lot of these GSPs are working on solutions through which also you can keep the trail, maintain the trail, and also generate the EWA bill. Alokbhai? Okay, we start. Okay, fair enough. So we move ahead with the discussion. We look at the website. There are other aspects which I would want to show till the OTP is generated. One of them is these basic laws, that is rules, notifications, circulars, etc. Right? If you know, the new rule has come, which is not yet updated here, but it is already updated on the CBEC. I have created a gist of what are the changes, whatever Manish Bhai has covered, I will not cover, but few changes which may be useful to you, I will try to cover that also. After that, there is a user manual, right? Bahut achha user manual diya hai. Iske andar one of them is how to use through SMS, how to use through Android application. Now in Android application, we will show you some features of the Android application. I think we should log in through our other login ID till such time he gets the OTP. So Android application, IMEI number of your mobile phone has to be put to generate a link, right? And that link will give you an Android application. So you cannot go to a Play Store and just say GST eWay bill and you will get the application. You will actually have to do some technical stuff to generate the link, and then that link will allow you to download the Android application, and that application can be used for generating the eWay bill. So it is a bit complicated, but that is also a model. But then over a period of time, they are planning to give this what you call the mobile application for the inspector separately, for the transporter separately, so that the QR code can be scanned through the mobile phone. So inspector will come and ask you for the QR code, and he will just pull out the data from the QR code through his application. So it will be as simple as that. And whatever Android application you will have, if you want to say see a EUA bill generated 5 years back or 3 years back through the oh, I thought he came like a magician from there. So when we used to do this STD calling, my uncle had a STD shop and we used to do STD calling. So USP was to make a call happen. But today the world has changed. Anyway, we'll put the OTP. Okay, username CA Alok Bhai, Alok Delia. Yeah, sorry. Okay, so very simple. He has to just select a username, which is simple to remember. He remembers it quickly. And password. That's it. And the registration is done. Right? So you need not put a lot of information into the registration process. But yes, everyone has to separately do a registration as a supplier or as a recipient. Right? And as a transporter, there are two options. One is a transporter may be registered transporter with GST or maybe unregistered transporter with GST. So for both registered as well as unregistered transporter, there is an option to register with the portal, right? So even if the transporter is unregistered, he doesn't have an option but to register with the portal. And what is the minimum requirement that the transporter should have to be registered with the portal is just a PAN number. Uska sirf PAN number hona chahiye. और कोई डेटा की जरूरत नहीं है. एंड वंस द पैन नंबर इज पुट, यू विल गेट अ ट्रांसपोर्टर आईडी व्हिच इज अ यूनिक आईडी व्हिच यू गिव टू ऑल योर कस्टमर्स. व्हेनेवर दे जनरेट द ईवे बिल, दे कैन पुट दैट ट्रांसपोर्टर आईडी इनटू द ईवे बिल एंड दे कैन आइडेंटिफाई यू और असाइन यू द कंसाइनमेंट. आपको कंसाइनमेंट असाइन कर सकते हो. ओके, सो आलोक भाई का हो गया. See, this is the dashboard. They have made a beautiful dashboard which says that now Alok Bhai is already logged in after registration, and the dashboard says that EUA bills generated, EUA bills cancelled, EUA bills rejected. This will give you a overview of how many EUA bills were generated, how many were cancelled, how many were rejected, etc. Right? And EUA bills generated by other parties on my GSTN. Like someone else is generating, like our transporter generates the EUA bill, then my EUA bill is rejected by other parties. See, if the EUA bill is rejected by other party, you have created it, but someone has rejected it, it will give you the list on the dashboard. Only problem with the dashboard is, currently it is like the old trunk call or SDD line, it is getting updated one day after. So, aaj agar koi data aaya, to kal wo dashboard pe dikhata hai. But it is okay, it is just matter of time. They are trying to stabilize with the model, but already when you click on the dashboard, you go inside, it will show the data, but it will not reflect on the dashboard. It will say so zero as of now, but internally there may be 4 or 5 already assigned, so you can go inside and see the data in the dashboard. Right? Now let's create a transporter registration. So is it simple or it is very difficult? Very simple, right? So mentally we here want to do is to try and tell you that it is not very difficult, it is easy, just try it out. Now let's register Dinesh Bhai. He is our chairman of IT committee and I thank him for giving me the opportunity. Apart from that, I also asked him that can we make you a transporter, right? So transporter ko kya chahiye? Sirf ek PAN number chahiye. और अगर कोई बोलता है कि मेरे पास पैन नंबर भी नहीं है तो विल यू एक्सेप्ट हिम एज अ ट्रांसपोर्टर? आंसर इज नो, राइट? सो लेट्स नॉट आस्क सच क्वेश्चंस इन द बिग फोरम्स. यस्टरडे आई वाज विद अ डिपार्टमेंट ऑफिसर एंड वी वर डूइंग सिमिलर सेशन इन महाड़ इन द रायगढ़ डिस्ट्रिक्ट एंड समवन आस्क्ड दैट अगर ट्रांसपोर्टर के पास पैन नंबर भी नहीं है तो क्या करूँ. सो द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफिसर आस्क्ड द इंडस्ट्री गाइज टू से दैट क्या आप इसको ट्रांसपोर्टर मानेंगे. So everyone said that no, this kind of transporter we don't entertain in the industry, right? So just a PAN number is required to get himself registered, and an OTP will get generated, and he just need to give the OTP so that a transporter ID gets generated. So these are the details that we need to put for anyone who gets registered. These are very basic details, PIN number, PIN code, etc. Constitution of the business. So just
Kumar. Dinesh Kumar.
So maybe.
Name is Dinesh.
As of now, no. There is no validation.
No, as of now, PAN validation.
Okay, already came. Okay, so validation is there. So the PAN number, name on the PAN card and the name here should match, right? So, and in this we can say proprietor, partnership, etc. So we will let's say proprietor as of now, and let's put the address.
Just do some, put something.
There is no validation as of now with regards to the address. So one can just put email ID, telephone number, STD number is also not required. You have to say one more thing, that is the premise is rented, leased, consent, shared, others, right? So, I think although there are no validations, we should be careful while taking the registration so that tomorrow, if you are asked for any details, you should be able to provide those details. As of now, it will accept anything. No, no, direct through PAN. It is optional. You can, you may or you may not connect the Aadhaar, right? But as of now, it is optional. Over a period of time, they will try and make this also compulsory.
As of now, they are saying,
"Theek hai, aa jao yaar." Welcome. Okay, there is an issue with the internet, I think.
This is the last mail where you can directly get the transfer.
No OTP will come here, right?
The OTP will come to your mobile. And once you accept, you give the OTP, it will generate the passport and password and confirm. Internet down again. Let's try once more. So, while he's trying, we should also look at certain other tricky parts. So, one of them is we should tell all our clients to collect the master data of the transporters along with the transporter ID. Right? So, most of the systems will not have the transporter ID as a column or field in their master data. Right? Or most of them, most of us in Delhi, when we maintain, we don't even maintain the name of the transporter. We just say freight account debit to bank account, right? That's it. So we need to now maintain the transporter master along with the transporter ID in our master data. One more suggestion on system side is we need to maintain the suppliers or the customers master data along with the approximate kilometer of the ship to address, right? So, you don't have to look at it later. Say, your ship to address is in Aurangabad and you are in Mumbai. You know the approximate distance, right? Although there can be a lot of debate that it may be air miles, A miles, O miles. As of now, you are not restricted to say, you have 920 kilometers, you have 950 or 1020 kilometers. Right, so put 50-60 kilometers here and there, and once for all, please put the approximate kilometers. Google map is a good indicator to give you the approximate distance, right? And you can put that distance into the supplier master. तो सप्लायर मास्टर और ट्रांसपोर्टर मास्टर ये दोनों ठीक से क्रिएट करना चाहिए राइट. सो इट विल गिव यू लॉट ऑफ इंफॉर्मेशन व्हाई डूइंग द ट्रांजैक्शन. थर्ड इंपॉर्टेंट व्हाई सो एनीवे सो लेट्स यूज वन मोर ट्रांसपोर्टर आईडी वी हैव क्रिएटेड सो वी कैन यूज दैट ट्रांसपोर्टर आईडी फॉर फॉर द एग्जांपल पर्पस राइट. सो देन व्हेन यू want to also track certain other information like transporter ke sath uske vehicle numbers right. If you can track the list of vehicle numbers along with the transporter master it will be very very useful data for you to maintain. So what we should actually tell our clients whoever is practicing or whoever is in the industry is to start collecting this information and also educating the transporters or the contractors who are handling the transport to give this data to you so that on the last date you are not stuck for the lack of information. Kyunki usko aap phone karke puchenge wo bolega transporter id kya hota hai right yeah what is the number of kilometers right. So all those confusions have to be done away with right. So this is the login of a transporter, just a sample that we had created. Let's now create an e-way bill, right? This is as a trial. So generate new e-way bill. You can also try, yeah.
Sir, actually one question. When we are generating, we have pressed application on this project right now. Before the data is temporary, so it would get deleted automatically all the registrations.
Everything, including registration, everything has to be done afresh.
Then how could we get a transporter ID of the person?
He knows today that what I need to put tomorrow, right? If we experiments,
transporter ID is generated as GST. First two digits will be the state code, then it will be the PAN number, then it will be the say entity. It is the first entity on that PAN number. So as the GST is generated, on the same lines transporter ID will be generated. So even if I registered on 1st February, my PAN number is going to remain the same. My state is going to remain the same. So the ID will be the same. Yeah.
So all registrations need to be made afresh.
As of now, they are saying that all registrations also need to be made afresh on 1st of Feb. Although you have made a registration beforehand, you have to re-register yourself on 1st of Feb because they are going to flush the entire data from the portal. It is going to take 5 minutes, sir, if you are wanting to do it. If you want to do chakka jam, there is no choice, right?
So,
7
o'clock in the morning, no crowd.
Yeah, no crowd. Even 1 o'clock in the night, there is no crowd. And you need not have to physically go to the office and prepare some document and send, right? You just need to open a portal and register yourself in 2 to 3 minutes time, right? See, there are problem statements and there are issues with everything in the world. Right? So we have to see what is the solution to it instead of worrying about. Anyways, so let's try and generate a e-way bill. I think that would be more interesting. I created an entire PPT and then I thought there is no point in showing you PPT again. Many will show you, but then let's look at the portal per se. So so here is the e-way bill entry form. Right? Again, a very simple form, and most of the data is filled up. You just need to put the you just need to say that it is a tax invoice or just go to that bill of supply or bill of entry or challan or credit note or others right. Aapko others diya hai agar kuch bhi ho gaya then you can go and use others. Say if you don't have any answer out of these 4 or 5 then we can always go and say others. And one more thing I would want to tell you, that let us not go to legal issues that कैसे वो फिर देखा जाएगा court of law में फिर उसमें क्या होगा, because initial phase everyone is going to play with the portal. So don't be very worried about कि tax invoice किसको बोलते हैं. Let us go and read the law. Let's have a basic understanding that okay this is what is required to be done and let us try and do it. पहला थोड़ा एक दो round घुमाते हैं उसके बाद वो ऑटो पायलट मोड में जाएगा. दैट टाइम वी कैन इंप्रूव ऑन सर्टेन थिंग्स. Then document number. Say we will have some document number test slash 001 as a sample, and then we say document date. Then all other data is already filled up. Yeah. GSTN number from and to, right? आपको consignor और consignee दोनों डालना है, right? Many times you are a seller and there is some other consignor and there is some other consignee. So no problem, you can always put both parties' data into this, and you can send the, you can prepare the e-way bill. See, automatically the data is populated here. You just need to put the GSTN number and it will automatically populate the data of the company or the firm, whatever, which is registered in this GSTN number, right? Right, so enter the URP if the person is unregistered, right? This is going to come in many cases where B2C transactions happen, right? You don't have the registration number of the other party, what will you do? You will have to register, put URP there, and that's it, right? You are not even asked as of now the name, address, etc. of the unregistered person. If you can put fabulous, if you cannot put, it's okay, right? The question is whether you want to keep the trail or not want to keep the trail. Then item details, right? This is also simple, but one point that I would try to make is before this 1.5 crore ke niche ke jo bhi log the unko HSN code compulsory nahi tha, but now because of UA bill the HSN code has taken a backdoor entry and it is compulsory for everyone to put at least two digits of HSN code, right? So this makes the HSN code almost compulsory for everyone to maintain. So this will a bit complicate the life. So whoever has smaller clients, they should implement the client that inventory master ke saath kya add kar do, HSN code bhi add kar do, taki aapke inventory master, aapka jo banda hai jab real transaction karne jayega tab wo HSN code dhoondne na nikle diya leke, ya aapko excuse na banta hai ki mere paas HSN code nahi tha isiliye maine transaction delay kiya ya nahi kiya, right? So certain things we can be proactive about. So say for example computer, you can put description, UQN jo hai, there is a UQC, there is a protocol that has to be followed. Say for example you want to say unit, pieces, so you can say units, UNITS, waise hi likhna padega usme, usme drop down nahi hai unfortunately, but they have given this list in the help, so you have to see in the help and copy paste or write again in the box. अदरवाइज वो ये करेगा, वो रुकाएगा वहाँ। हाँ, bulk, if you want to upload bulk, Mehul will show you the bulk file also, through which you can upload bulk. You know, say for example, you have 50 products or 100 products, 100 invoices in a day. You need not go and create UA bills this way. You can create the UA bills directly through an Excel file. एक Excel file में data भरो, upload करो, सब UA bill number automatic populate हो जाएगा, that we will show you later, but the point is it has got a drop down wherein you can select from the drop down when you are filling up in the Excel file. ठीक है, so यहाँ पे Mehul will just put the data and we can see the rates etc getting auto filled up in the information, right? I was asked that what is the value of this transaction. Actually the value is not 50,000, 50,000 plus whatever amount. So when you are doing a billing lesser than 50,000, be careful that it should be, if it is hitting 50,000 including tax, you need to create an e-way bill. But I would actually propose for the bit of a larger organization with a good team, why don't you create e-way bill for a smallest of the transaction? There is no point of saying that no need, unless you are doing over the counter transaction, like you are doing sale of hardware or printing material or anything, then it's a different story. Otherwise no point in you know, being conservative, so say ki 50,000 ke niche to mat karo, 50,000 ke upar hai to karo. I would rather request that we should adopt it for everything and it is free for you to do. So road, rail, air, ship, right? Either mode of transport with diya hua hai. So you can choose whatever mode of transport you are going to use. And as Manish bhai said, if you are going with by ship, there is no ship number. So you have to mention the bill of lading number. If you are using the railway, then rail receipt. If you are using airway, then airway bill. So whatever is the document number, you need to adopt to that document number there and put the data accordingly. So transporter ID can be of anyone, even if it is going through railway. आप पूछेंगे railway का क्या transporter ID? So right, so railway will give you the transporter ID, but as of now, say if you are using an agency who is picking up the material from your place, putting it in the railway yard and then putting in the railway and, you know, moving it finally. So you can use that ID as well as the transporter ID. You need not worry about ki mujhe railway ka ID chahiye ya airlines ka ID chahiye, lekin they will also create the ID. So if you are yourself dropping the material at the airlines and you want to, you know, use it like a courier, then there will be a airline ID also. So approximate distance, right? So here you need to look at the Google map or something and find out what is the distance. Put some distance there. So as you know, every 100 kilometers you are given one day to do the transportation. So even if it is 102, you are given 2 days. And even if it is 199, still you are given 2 days. But even if it is 201, you are given 3 days. Now he who is making the system will have to make the system in some form. So we should not try and worry about it, but try and see what is the solution. So whenever we feel that it may go overboard, we can always go for 102 instead of 99, right? Then vehicle number. Now vehicle number is not compulsory. If you are putting the material, you are carrying the material to the transportation hub, which is inter 10 kilometers. Say if you are sending a material from Kalyan to Bhiwandi for going to Ahmedabad, from Kalyan to Bhiwandi you are using your own tempo. So you need not worry about putting the vehicle number on the material if it is being sent to the transporter. If it is sent to your own factory in other premise, or if it is sent to any other job worker or anyone else, then you need to compulsorily put the UAV, vehicle number, even if the distance is below 10 kilometers. That is the change that has come just in the last changes that have come. So they have said that only for moving the material to the transporter within 10 kilometers, no need to put the vehicle number. Otherwise, vehicle number is compulsory. Okay, so we'll just put some vehicle number. And people will also have a question that agar transporter ke paas bhej raha ho aur vehicle number nahi hai to kya hoga. So UA bill will be generated, but it will say that this UA bill is not valid for movement ke liye valid nahi hai, aisa aayega, right? UA bill generate ho jayega aapka, right? Aur agar aapko kisi ne pakad liya us 10 kilometer mein to aap ye dikha sakte. So it will be valid for a movement of 10 kilometers, because I also had a question that if it is saying that UAV is not valid for movement, how can I use for 10 kilometers? But that is legally permissible. If you are inside 10 kilometers, you can use that UAV. And then what you will do? Jab transporter ke paas chala gaya, aapko ek vehicle assign ho gaya, so you have to put the vehicle number at that juncture. Come on. Right. So ये पार्ट ए स्लिप जनरेट हो गया अपना. पार्ट ए मतलब आपने मटेरियल भेजा, व्हीकल असाइन नहीं हुआ है, व्हीकल इज नॉट असाइन, ओनली यू हैव सेंड द मटेरियल. दिस पार्ट ए विल बी जनरेटेड, इट विल शो ऑल द डेटा विद रिगार्ड्स टू द रेसिपिएंट एंड द ट्रांसपोर्टर एंड ऑल्सो द वैल्यू ऑफ गुड्स एक्सेट्रा, राइट? वॉट एवर यू हैव पुट इन द इंफॉर्मेशन. इट विल ऑल्सो गिव यू अ यूनिक नंबर, right? You can see that unique number is also generated, and the enter date along with the time, 8 or 17, right? So there are certain clauses where 24 hours is mentioned, 72 hours is mentioned, So they follow exact 24, exact 72. They don't follow completed days model. Niche. You can print this and give it to your transporter before he assigns the vehicle. Our transporter has some job. So you have to, now people have one more question, that if I am transporting from my own vehicle, what will happen? I am not the transporter, but I have a truck through which I do the transportation. In that case, you have to, as a consigner, also register as a transporter. So usme kuch alag karna nahi aapko, usme ek option aa jata hai, you can register as a, Rahul, can you show that? See, as a transporter, just go there and update that you are also a transporter apart from a consigning or a consigner, right? Throwing out? No, no, it is not your. Okay, so transporter ko humne assign kar diya. Ab hum transporter ke andar ja ke dekhte hain. कि उसमें क्या दिख रहा है. सो द प्रॉब्लम इज व्हेन द गवर्नमेंट वॉज थिंकिंग अबाउट दिस मॉडल ऑफ हाउ टू सेंट्रलाइज द डेटाबेस ऑफ मूवमेंट, इट हिट एट अ रोड ब्लॉक टू से दैट इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल इफ ईच एंड एवरी कंपनी मेंटेन्स दैट ओन चलान और ओन रिकॉर्ड्स. So can we make one nation, one portal, right, which can allow everyone to generate EV bills, right? So they have not kept it very, very tight, but at the same time, they would have this validation of this EV bill across the country. Wherever you go, this EV bill is considered to be valid, and all the EV bills that are going on, like 402 or eSugam, all will stop. So Karnataka or other states who have adopted EV bills will completely stop. So right. So now we can see this number getting assigned to the transporter who was selected while creating the part A. Right. Part A banaya humne EWB01 ka. So ab the transporter has to go and select and put the vehicle number. Usko vehicle number dalne ki suvidha wahan mil jayegi. Wherein he can change the mode of transport also. He can put it from road to rail or ship or whatever he wants to put, and he can put the vehicle number. So what is this place of change? Say for example, goods are moving from Kalyan to Bhiwandi, and from Bhiwandi they are moving to say Vasai. The place of change of the vehicle is Bhiwandi. Then again from Vasai they are moving to Ahmedabad, so place of change is Vasai. So transporter can change the place n number of times. Whenever the vehicle changes, the place of change also is to be updated. Now this place of change is not a fixed field. One can put whatever. It is a free hand. आप कुछ भी लिखो. तो कोई दहिसर नाका लिख देगा, right? और कोई बोलेगा चिंचोड़े फाटा. So it will become an issue over a period of time. But as of now, the government is saying we will not block this field. Over a period of time, we are expecting that the government will come up with a GPS model wherein it will say that वहाँ पे जो डालेंगे exactly वो GPS को assign कर देगा, right? So it is a matter of time where you will see the changes happening in this structure, but you will have to put the GPS ID instead of putting anything else, right? Just a matter of time.
There will be 10 ambulances, there will be 20, 750.
Right, so there will be a confusion. That is what I am trying to say.
Number of bandwidth will be 100.
100, right. So it will become very difficult. Abhi washi kitna hai? Kam se kam 150 washi hai, Maharashtra. So the problem is, you can say that, oh, I was talking about the washi in Raigad district. I was not talking about your regular washi in Navi Mumbai. Right, so there will be an issue with regards to these things. Your Mazgao, how many Mazgao are there? Cannot imagine. आज मुंबई में हम लोग को एक ही मजगाव पता है, but there are many.
If consignor has transported its telephone itself.
Yeah, 100%. So if he puts the vehicle number, he can also update the transporter details. राइट, वहाँ व्हीकल नंबर का ऑप्शन था लेकिन मेहुल ने डाला नहीं वहां पे, इसके लिए ट्रांसपोर्टर को असाइन हुआ, ट्रांसपोर्टर ने व्हीकल नंबर डाला. सी व्हाट प्रोसेस यू वांट टू फॉलो विद योर क्लाइंट इज व्हाट यू नीड टू डिस्कस विद हिम बिफोर एंड. बिजनेस मॉडल पे डिपेंड करता है कि व्हाट इज ए सुटेबल मॉडल, बट द गवर्नमेंट इज सेइंग किसी ना किसी को ये एक्टिविटी करना है ईवे बिल का, राइट. सो यू कैन पुट द रीजन ड्यू टू ब्रेक डाउन, ड्यू टू ट्रांसशिपमेंट, अदर्स प्लीज स्पेसिफाई, राइट. आपको अदर्स हर जगह दिए बिकॉज गवर्नमेंट वॉन्ट्स दिस टू रन, राइट, बिकॉज देर आर मेनी क्रिएटिव पीपल हु विल कम विद एक्सक्यूज कि सर उसमें ड्रॉप डाउन नहीं था तो हम क्या करें, हमने फिर छोड़ दिया, ईवे बिल ही नहीं जनरेट किया. तो बोलेगा कुछ नहीं तो अदर्स डालना चाहिए था तुमको. सो जस्ट से सबमिट एंड द ईवे बिल अलॉन्ग विद द ब्यूटीफुल क्यूआर कोड इज क्रिएटेड. वो क्यूआर कोड से आप फिर स्कैनिंग कर सकते हैं. अभी तो स्कैनिंग शुरू नहीं हुआ बट देयर विल बी अ क्यूआर कोड थ्रू विच द स्कैनिंग विल हैपन ऑफ द ईवे बिल. And the e-way bill will be given to the transporter. And there will be a trail that will be created. देखो नीचे एक trail create हो रहा है. पहला movement road यहाँ से यहाँ तक एक हो गया. अब Mehul can go and update this new transport mode. तो पहले वाला delete नहीं करेगा. वो भी maintain करेगा. उसके नीचे और एक transport mode maintain करेगा. तो same transporter transship कर रहा है. तो नए ट्रांसपोर्टर के बाद वही ईवे बिल होगा क्या? आंसर इज नो. ही हैज टू टेक अ फ्रेश प्रिंट आउट व्हिच शुड हैव हिज व्हीकल नंबर एंड डिटेल्स, राइट. सो व्हेनेवर अ ट्रक इज कॉट द क्वेश्चन आस्क्ड वुड बी इज द व्हीकल नंबर वैलिड एंड इज द शिपमेंट बीइंग यू नो इंटेंडेड टू कैरी इन दिस व्हीकल, राइट. सो इफ दैट इज एस्टैब्लिश्ड देयर शुड नॉट बी एनी इश्यू. ट्रांसपोर्टर विल बी एबल टू फाइंड आउट कि कितना ईवे बिल उसको असाइन हुआ है, राइट, बिकॉज़ ट्रांसपोर्टर विल हैव टू फाइंड आउट फ्रॉम समवेयर, राइट. सो ही हैज वेरियस वेज और मोड्स टू फाइंड आउट हाउ मेनी ईवे बिल्स आर जनरेटेड एंड असाइन टू द ट्रांसपोर्टर. देखो वहां पे ईवे बिल जनरेटेड बाय मी 2 आ गया. ईवे बिल असाइन हुआ 0 दिखा रहा है लेकिन एक्चुअली असाइन हुआ है. As of now, the dashboard is showing the old data, but it is work in progress. So they are actually building the speed so that you will be able to see this data live. But transporter can check out physically वहाँ पे ईवे बिल नंबर डाल के कि देखो कौन सा ईवे बिल असाइन हुआ है. So you will find out this ईवे बिल which is just assigned by Mehul to the transporter, right? And he can now update the ईवे बिल again with the new transshipment if any. राइट right? लेकिन बहुत लोग मुझे एक क्वेश्चन पूछते हैं कि कैन दी ट्रांसपोर्टर आई डी बी अपडेटेड. द आंसर इज नो. वंस यू पुट अ ट्रांसपोर्टर आई डी यू आर होल्डिंग हिम रिस्पॉन्सिबल टिल द एंड. दैट इज द अजम्पशन दैट द गवर्नमेंट इज टेकिंग, राइट. सो द ट्रांसपोर्टर इंटर से कैन चेंज द ट्रांसपोर्टर बट ही कैन नॉट देन अपडेट द डेटा ऑफ द ट्रांसपोर्टर आई डी इन टू द डिटेल्स. ही कैन जस्ट अपडेट द व्हीकल नंबर, दैट्स इट. So that is as of now an issue in one way because there are many cases where the transporter also changes, right? 3, 4, 5 transporters come in the process. But the government is saying that there is one agency who takes care of all the 5 transporters and we will track it as a single as of now. Okay. Now let's look at the cancellation of EVA bill. Say galti se EVA bill ban gaya. Right, so can I cancel the EVA bill? Again, Mehul has to go and log in as a right, and he can go and cancel the EVA bill. And it will the worst part of it. This is it will send an OTP. You have to put the OTP and the bill will get cancelled. But it will not ask you once more, are you sure you want to delete? So if you delete a live UA bill, you are in a problem. So as of now, they are not asking any validation. Are you sure? Right? In upon IRCTC, when we go and put all the data and say cancel this ticket, it will ask twice. Are you sure you want to, you know, because the person, we are used to this kind of a model. So we may, you know, say delete and then say nahi karna hai. But that option is not there. Once you say okay, gone is gone. Right, you can say reason, duplicate create ho gaya hai. Right, people are asking, duplicate ho gaya toh kya karna? Kuch nahi karna, delete kar lena. Within 24 hours you can delete the UAB. If you are not identifying a duplicate within 24 hours, that bill is not duplicate, it is intentionally duplicate. That is what government feels. Right, the second order cancelled or data entry error or mistake, they are also allowing you an option to say that galti ho gaya data dalne. And the lastly, they are saying others, right? If you, otherwise people will want to use it as an excuse. Ki ye teeni option hai, mera to kuch chautha hi issue. So but that's it. You can say cancel and the email will get cancelled. So it is as simple as that, right? We will look at certain other aspects of this portal. One of them is if your vehicle, let's do a consolidated email. That is what we want to show it to you. So how we consolidate, the transporter has got 5 UA bills assigned. Now he wants to consolidate it because it is the, there is a provision where the transporter has to consolidate all the UA bills into one. And one vehicle is used to carry this material from some location to some other location. So that is also one thing that we need to see. Who are assigned here? Assigned the UA bills. Process we will just show because we have created one UAB, so multiple UABs are not there as of now, but we can show a process. Right, a simple process. Here you put the vehicle details or ek saath aapke jitne bhi UABs hai, wahan niche reflect ho jayenge. You just need to tick 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 and say consolidate. We don't have data here, but once we have a data, plus 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 sign dabayenge to niche niche line item khul jayegi, wherein you can put multiple UA bills in a list and just say submit. It will create a consolidated UA bill. Aisa kuch matlab jadoo karna nahi hai, right? If you look at the transporter model, many clients are transporters, so I am saying that transporters do this manually. Wo log karte hi hai boss. वो लोग जब ड्राइवर निकलता है ना, तभी पूरा लिस्ट निकालते हैं, उसको बताते हैं, देख चार एलआर जा रही है, एक मस्जिद को अंदर छोड़ना है, एक वासी छोड़ना है, एक यहाँ छोड़ना है, एक यहाँ छोड़ना है, ये एलआर नंबर ये है, तेरे पास एक लिस्ट बना और रख, एंड वो क्लीनर को और उसको दोनों को लिस्ट पकड़ा देते हो, राइट? बिकॉज दे हैव टू कंसोलिडेट दिस एंटायर ट्रांजेक्शन, सो दे आर डूइंग इट, दे जस्ट नीड टू डू इट ऑन लाइन, दैट्स इट. सो अपार्ट फ्रॉम दिस, this is a cancelled, थोड़ा time लग रहा है, but cancelled will show this way, will show that this this UA bill is cancelled, right? Now let's look at some other reports. Reject is very useful, right? Many times you find a TDS being credited to your account 26S, and you don't have any option but to accept it, right? And sometimes you feel happy that वो 5000 का TDS आया. Even you don't know, पीछे 50,000 का इनकम भी आया, right? And that income is virtual and you have to pay 30% tax on it. And what deduction you will get is only 5,000, that is 10%, right? तो 20% का जेब से डालना पड़ेगा, पैसा तो कुछ मिलेगा नहीं. लेकिन इसमें ऐसा नहीं है, you have given an option कि if you find any UA bill being assigned to you within 72 hours, you can cancel. 72 hours मतलब लगभग कितने दिन हो गए? 3 और 3 6 दिन हो गए, right? और 24 into 3 3 दिन हो गए. So you have 3 days to cancel any UA bill that is wrongly assigned to you, right? The other party can cancel for 24 hours. See, the beauty of this is he cannot cancel after 24 hours. But the recipient, if he finds that a galti se ho gaya hai, to kya kar sakta hai? Within 3 days any time he can say I want to reject this UA bill. कर रहे नहीं आपको एक्सेप्ट, ऑटोमेटिक एक्सेप्ट. अगर आपने 72 आवर से कुछ नहीं बोला, कुछ नहीं कर देगा क्योंकि आपके लिए पॉसिबल नहीं है. व्हेन थाउजेंड्स ऑफ ट्रांजैक्शंस हैपन इट इज डिफिकल्ट फॉर वन टू एक्सेप्ट बट रिजेक्ट इज इजी. सो यू कम टू नो दैट अ रॉन्ग यूएबल एंट्री हैज कम इन योर पोर्टल यू जस्ट नीड टू गो देयर एंड रिजेक्ट दैट्स इट.
सो दैट मींस यू हैव टू बी प्री इंडिकेटेड दैट गोज आर कमिंग.
Yeah, because when the UAB is generated, all three, that is supplier, recipient, transporter, all will get SMS. They are planning to put an email alert also. Abhi tak chalu nahi hua, but there will be an email alert. Plus, you will get on this dashboard. What are the UABs assigned to you? So, as the Manish bhai said, morning you come, do the puja and then see this dashboard. What are the wrong UABs assigned and just cancel it. Yeah. Yeah, there is there. That Mehul is going to show. I discussed this. We are going to show it. Yeah. Yeah, same vehicle number. So wrong will be updated. So you have a choice. If you know that it is wrong, you can change it. आपको edit करने का option है. Let people who want to leave, please leave because it is going to take another 15-20 minutes. No problem. I know it is 8:30, so many would be in rush. और किसको जाना है तो please आराम से एक मिनट रुक जाएंगे हम. Fine. So so reports. So you can just click on this and outward supplies, inward supplies, CEWB generated by me, consolidated UA bills generated by me, cancelled UA bills, rejected UA bills by me, assigned to the transporters. Iska pura list aapko ye report se mil jayega. And I am sure they are going to give an Excel download. As of now they have not given, but there will be an Excel download which can be easily used for you to do an exercise. Then other UAB reports generated by others, rejected by others, दूसरे ने आपने बनाया दूसरे ने cancel कर दिया. उसके बाद assigned to me for transport, say any transporter के हिसाब से आपको अगर कुछ assigned हुआ, right? So they will give you all these reports readily available, right? They have done it thoughtfully, ऐसा लगता है मुझे देखने के बाद. फिर masters. Now you have an option to download your masters, that is supplier master, inventory master. ये खुद create करने वाला है और आपको ये exception report देगा कि कितने ऐसे UAB आपने बनाए हैं जिसका master data नहीं था आपके पास इसमें, right? So it will create a backend master for supplier, for inventory, for transporter, everything, right? So this will be a very fast tool because it will have master data, so you will have to type just से अपन आलोक भाई का करें तो ए एल ओ करेंगे तब तक आ जाएगा पूरा, राइट? सो इट विल मेंटेन द मास्टर डेटा एट द बैक एंड एंड यू नो सो डुप्लीकेट ईवे बिल्स जनरेटेड वो वहां पे दे देगा आपको, राइट? क्लाइंट मास्टर्स नॉट अपडेटेड दे देगा आपको, सप्लायर मास्टर्स नॉट अपडेटेड दे देगा आपको, प्रोडक्ट मास्टर्स, ट्रांसपोर्ट मास्टर्स, कुछ भी आपने अपडेट नहीं किया लेकिन ईवे बिल जनरेट किया तो आपको अलर्ट करेगा कि आप मास्टर बना दो. डुप्लीकेट ईवे बिल इज व्हेन यू हैव यूज द सेम नंबर, लाइक सेम इनवॉइस नंबर फॉर डूइंग टू ट्रांजैक्शंस. फॉर एग्जांपल ही सेड, मनीष भाई सेड, वन इनवॉइस 10 ट्रक्स में जा रहा है मटेरियल, तो यू विल हैव से 10 ईवे बिल्स व्हिच विल शो डुप्लीकेट. But you know at the back end that it is correct, so there is no problem. But sometimes it is actually duplicate, so you have to go and delete it. So it will not stop you from creating duplicates, but it will give you an exception report. You then use it or not use it.
So if this consignment went to a ship to us in different states and a different entities,
yeah.
So we have to create two EVA bills, right?
Two EVA bills for what?
Consigner is in Tamil Nadu,
Bill 2
is Mumbai and
Ship 2
is say Karnataka.
Yeah, you have to create two UAB bills for that. that Manishba already explained, that you will have to create two e-way bills for bill to ship to kind of model transactions, and if you have a third consignor in that scenario. If you have two, only bill to and ship to, no issue, you can create one e-way bill and accommodate everything. But if you have three addresses to be put, there is no choice. One more point is, from the GST regulation standpoint also, it is logical that there are two sets of transactions that are happening at the back end, right? One is the transaction of movement of goods from location A to location B, and other is the transaction of invoicing between A to C and C to B, right? So you have to trail the entire transaction. So if you look at it, EUA bill 2 is logical. Another very logical thing is, each invoice should have an EUA bill. So one cannot say that there is an invoice and there is no EUA bill if it is material. So it will help you generate the trail in that fashion also. Product master, client master, supplier master. One single product can be updated through product master. One single customer, or even Excel, as she said. I think this is a juncture when we can show the Excel file also, how it looks. We just downloaded the template. It is a good template, very easy template, where they have given the option to update bulk transporter master or supplier master or customer master, all that to inventory master to the Excel. Sorry. So you just need to put the data. It has a good validator also, which validates if there are duplicate transactions or any issues with regards to the formatting of the data. It will validate you, and it will allow you to upload the data directly from this what you call the Excel sheet, which will be getting converted into automatically into a JSON file, right? You need to enable macros to use this Excel, as you do for creating a C form upload or any other thing. Nowadays it is very common, so I need not get into that, right? So validate karo, JSON file banao, khatam ho gayi baat, aur upload karo. Abhi ye bulk upload chal raha hai kya? Answer is no. Ye abhi chal nahi raha hai. Lekin they have given the template, and when we are uploading, they are saying that use the latest template. So I think they have come up with the new template, but the template is not updated in the system. So maybe they will come up with a new template, thoda idhar udhar changes karke, and then you will be able to upload the data through JSON. I don't know the legal side too much, but I think that it will start from 1st of Feb only for the interstate transactions, and for the intrastate transactions from 1st of June. So I don't think you will be given a leeway to say that after 1st of Feb till 1st of March you again enjoy the trial period, right? हम लोग बचपन में कहते हैं नहीं 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 ये तो ट्रायल था यार, एक बार दिया अभी बार बार क्यों ट्रायल चाहिए. So these are real business transactions, so you don't need again and again to say that it is. So you can upload the JSON file from upload the file.
It is not allowing to upload.
Okay. So you can upload this JSON file directly to and check. So the template is available from here. Go in the template. There is some teething trouble. Maybe over a period of time this should be getting sorted out. See, these are the what you call, this is the screen from which one can download all the templates. जो भी आपको टेम्पलेट चाहिए वो यहाँ जाके यू कैन डाउनलोड. ईवे बिल एट्रीब्यूट्स, कंसॉलिडेटेड ईवे बिल एट्रीब्यूट्स, जेसॉन फॉर्मेट, कंसॉलिडेटेड जेसॉन फॉर्मेट फाइल्स, ये सब मिल जाएगा. सो मेनी पीपल हु आर वेरी सॉफ्टवेयर सेवी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टार्टेड वर्किंग ऑन दिस. दे हैव डाउनलोडेड एंड टोल्ड देयर वेंडर्स, सॉफ्टवेयर वेंडर, कि ऐसा वाला डाउनलोड चाहिए, अपलोड चाहिए. तो रेडीमेड यू विल गेट फ्रॉम योर सेल्स रजिस्टर डायरेक्टली अ डम्प विच कैन बी अपलोडेड इन टू दी पोर्टल. तो ये भी हो सकता है. सब यूजर, दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. Sub-user creation, there are companies with multiple people working in multiple departments, multiple sub, what you call, units. Many times supplier, supply mein, logistics mein alag bande rehte hain, accounts mein alag bande rehte hain, purchase mein alag rehte hain. So how do you handle that? Sub OTP, agar ek bande ko aaya to OTP lete rehte pagal ho jayega, right? So what they have done is they have given an option, a very smart option to call as sub user. So you can create number of sub users, and in sub users you can give them mobile number, phone number. जो बड़ी ऑर्गेनाइजेशन उनको ये भी प्लानिंग कर लेना चाहिए कि मेरे में सब यूजर कौन कौन रहेंगे, किसके मोबाइल पे ओटीपी जाएगा, और वो उनको पहले से बोल देना चाहिए, उनको थोड़ा ट्रेनिंग दे देना चाहिए कि कैसे यूज करना है इसका, राइट? सो इन द सब यूजर देयर आर सिक्स लेयर्स इन विच दे हैव स्प्रेड द ऑथेंटिकेशन. कॉम्प्लिकेट नहीं किया उन्होंने ऑथेंटिकेशन, लेकिन छह तरह के ऑथेंटिकेशन बना दिया. यस नो अपने को सुधारना है वहां पे. एनेबल ईवेबिल, ये वो enable the consolidated e-bill option, enable the bill rejection, वो क्या क्या कर सकता है बंदा, तो उसको छह प्रकार से उसको validate करने का मौका दे रहे हैं, ठीक है? So these are the powers or authority matrix that you can create for that guy, ठीक है? Apart from that, ठीक है, ये सब users का हो गया. I think you can try this when you
In case of e-commerce operator,
e-commerce का अभी आया, recently आया. पहले जो रूल था 138 उसमें e-commerce का कहीं मेंशन नहीं था. अभी जो नया रूल आया है, आज जो आया है अभी 2-3 घंटे पहले, उसमें there is a e-commerce provision where the e-commerce operator can also, so it is not compulsory that he has to,
otherwise the seller will have to
work. Yes, that is normal.
But then the seller does not aware that who the e-commerce operator is going to assign that.
So then e-commerce operator has to. See, many cases the e-commerce operator tells the seller किससे order आया है. Invoice भी वही बना था, seller ही बना था. तो वो case में seller के पास सब data है, right? अगर seller के पास data नहीं है तो e-commerce operator को बनाना है. किसी ना किसी को बनाना है, ये पक्का है. Choice नहीं है आपको. ठीक है, SMS registration. You can register for SMS, you can register for Android. So Android के लिए IMEI number डालना है, कौन से फोन में Android application चल सकता है, ठीक है? ये थोड़ा technical है, इसके लिए क्या है, अगर if you want to find out your own phone number, phone का IMEI, तो there is a star hash 06, वो डालेंगे तो क्या होगा, उसका IMEI number आपका मिल जाएगा. And then you have to put that IMEI number. Have you done any time IMEI number निकाला है? तो निकाल के आपको वहाँ डालना है, और जैसे ही वो डालेंगे वैसे OTP आ जाएगा आपके SMS पे, आप SMS डाल के क्लोज कर सकते हैं, ठीक है? इसके अलावा Android app, there is an option, then you have to say you want to create Android app and just put the IMEI number and the Android app, and it will keep the trail of how many phones are having your e-way bill application running, ठीक है? So वो भी अच्छा है, मतलब किसी employee को छोड़ के गया है तो you have to delete it from here, then he will not be able to use the e-way bill. Freeze कर सकते हैं अपन उसको, right? So fabulous way of handle this situation. Apart from that update, so as transporter, as GSTN, and there was one more concept called as citizen. Manish bhai told ki citizen अगर कोई material लेके जा रहा है from location, इन्होंने एक 1.5 लाख रुपए का मैकबुक खरीदा और लेके जा रहे हैं फ्रॉम होम, फ्रॉम शॉप टू हिज ऑफिस, ही कैन आल्सो अपडेट इट एज अ सिटीजन एंड ही कैन क्रिएट एन ईवे बिल नंबर इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ द सप्लायर. दैट ऑप्शन इज आल्सो गोइंग टू कम, अभी आया नहीं है लेकिन बाहर के स्क्रीन में दिया है देखो उधर, सिटीजन का ऑप्शन. एज अ सिटीजन यू कैन क्रिएट दी, अब तक चल नहीं रहा है, वो एरर दे रहा है, बट ओवर अ पीरियड ऑफ टाइम दे विल एनेबल दैट प्रोसेस. आई थिंक दैट इज मेड purely for people who are going to collect, buy material from India and export, take it along with them in the flight somewhere else. So they want to claim a refund on the airport, right? So usko kuch to proof lagega ki maine kahan se kharida hai, kahan tak laya hai. Singapore mein system hai, you can claim the refund while you purchase something from Singapore, GST is charged. When you go out on the airport, you can show a bill and you can get the money back. सेम मॉडल लाने की कोशिश कर रहे हैं, इसके लिए शायद सिटीजन वाला मॉडल यहाँ पे लाया है।
Yes, I think Mule, anything else that you want to show?
Grievances, right? EWB4 करके जो फॉर्म है, which is with regards to grievances. If your vehicle is stuck for 30 minutes, you can EWB4 आप फाइल कर सकते हैं कि भाई without reason my vehicle is stuck. अब तक वो बना रहे हैं वो लोग, तो हाँ, so they will develop this as well very fast. ठीक है, I think these are the few things that we wanted to show you. You can look at the other side of the thing also, which was general alerts, notifications, etc. And use this portal properly. I think it is about trying and experimenting. It is not very tough. You should try it. Most of the CA offices, the issue is we look from as a Sanjay. Sanjay is I. So all our article students are like Sanjay. We tell them who thai che portal khule che ke nahi khulto, right? We are not seeing, we are just listening the portal. So our try was to make all the Dhritarashtra, you know, have eyes back and see themselves the portal. So we try to create this kind of a session to, you know, help you with the seeing the portal yourselves. I am sure you will be empowered with the learning that you had in both these sessions, and I will like to thank my committee, IT committee chairman, Dinesh Bhai, Uday Bhai, Maitri is not there. So all those have given me an opportunity, and I think be it GST, be it income tax, be it whatever, now the way is e-way. Thank you.
Thank you, Mitesh Bhai. Friends, this definitely calls for a vote of thanks, and I guess we spent 2 minutes on that. Mitesh Bhai, thank you for such a lucid demonstration of something which seemingly was German and now is easily understandable. Thank you, Mehul, for being able to present this with the help of just phones and not proper connectivity. So thank you both of you, and we carry it with a large round of applause.
Thank you.
Supplier and consumer.